Long been described as the world's largest ethnic group without a country of its own. They are poorly understood and often ignored. Now, I first traveled to the Kurdish areas of Turkey, Syria, and Iraq in 2002, and they are a people that have long been divided by borders, by linguistic differences, by politics, and occupation and assimilation as well. A lot has changed in the subsequent 12 years. For instance, when I first traveled from the Kurdish part of Syria to Iraq, I had to go by boat across this river. Today, there's a bridge there, and in August, we watched this incredibly disturbing sight of tens of thousands of Kurds streaming across that bridge, fleeing the offensive by ISIS militants. On this trip, we went the opposite direction into the Kurdish part of Syria and got an introduction to the Syrian Kurdish fighters who have been fighting ISIS for more than a year. And what's very striking is how much women are playing a frontline role in that war and in the leadership of the Kurdish enclaves of northern Syria that have grown up in the midst of a civil war over the past 3 years. We see very much that gender equality is important there, and that's astounding when you consider their enemies, their ISIS, which have been hiding women away from public life, and as we also learned, have been accused of kidnapping thousands, I'm talking thousands, of Kurdish women in Iraq who come from the Yazidi religious minority. They're viewed as infidels, as heretics by ISIS, which have justified their enslavement of these women, arguing that it is allowed within the Muslim holy book, the Quran. The Iraqi Kurdish authorities are calling this a genocidal policy. The scale of this kidnapping is mind-blowing, barbaric, and frankly hard to even comprehend, even for somebody like me who's been traveling through these blood-soaked lands for more than a decade. Ivan Watson, CNN, reporting from Istanbul.
And U.S. military advisors could be on their way to Iraq's volatile Anbar province soon. That is an ISIS stronghold. As Chief U.S. Security Correspondent Jim Shitto reports for us, Iraqi forces very much want the help.